The situation is heartbreaking and the damage is quite catastrophic. Earlier today, on March 28th of 2025 at 12:50 p.m. local time in Myanmar or Burma, a major magnitude 7.7 earthquake struck the nation's largest and most dangerous fault line. This earthquake was centered a mere 10 miles or 16 kilometers west of the nation's second most populous city, Mandalay. As the ground began to rapidly shake back and forth, cracks formed in walls, and then many structures partially or completely collapsed, including sadly some skyscrapers. The earthquake itself lasted for an estimated 69 seconds, causing widespread extreme damage, and while early reports note confirmation of only 150 deaths, I am quite sad to say that the scientific models, which have proven fairly accurate in the past, note this as a likely extreme underestimate. The USGS model, linked below, currently suggests a 71% chance that more than 10,000 fatalities occurred and a 36% chance that more than 100,000 fatalities occurred. I want everyone to remember that Myanmar or Burma is in the midst of a high-intensity civil war, and due to this fact, it will likely take some time to determine the full extent of the destruction. Don't get me wrong, sometimes these models can be quite incorrect and severely under or overestimate damage. However, when a major earthquake strikes Syria, southern Turkey, Armenia, Azerbaijan, Pakistan, Haiti, or Myanmar/Burma, my heart just sinks. The infrastructure in many of these locations just isn't well designed historically speaking to withstand major earthquakes, and death tolls often reach tens of thousands from past major events. Early information even notes that a skyscraper under construction in Bangkok, Thailand collapsed. I have an unverified opinion on why that tragedy occurred. You can see the point of failure in social media footage being the bottom three-story high pillars, marking the entire building as a massive and presumably unreinforced soft-story structure, which are infamously terrible during earthquakes. It should have never been built with that design in an area prone to occasional earthquake shaking, especially since early indications suggest the structure only experienced MMI-4 shaking. Please, don't build any more of these types of structures if they are not properly reinforced in areas which can even occasionally experience potentially damaging earthquake shaking. I beg you. Moving on, other notable damage this time back closer to the epicenter include the collapse of the major Ava Bridge in multiple segments, which had been standing since 1934. But why did this earthquake strike? While not widely known, Myanmar/Burma sits at the boundary of not two but three tectonic plates. Offshore of the west of the country, the Indian plate is subducting underneath the Burma microplate. However, the motion of the Indian plate is not straight east but angled north-northeast, so as a result, most of its motion is northwards rather than eastwards. As a result, this motion places significant strain on the boundary of the Burma microplate and the Eurasian plate, causing stress to be released on occasion via the movement of the Sagang fault. Today's earthquake was caused by a 250-kilometer or 155-mile-long segment of the Sagang fault rupturing and moving by as much as 5 meters or 16.4 feet. The motion was almost entirely horizontal, with very little, if any, vertical motion component to it, hence the nature of this major right lateral strike slip fault earthquake. However, another type of earthquake damage has also likely occurred, and I do not simply mean landslides, which are modeled as likely being widespread. Since much of the worst affected area is a massive alluvial plain with larger cities being in close proximity to riverbeds, very widespread liquefaction likely happened. Since these soils contain abundant groundwater that is largely held together by friction, an earthquake can cause this water to shift and then come out of the mixture, making the soil subside unevenly in sections. This can cause the ground to collapse underneath the building in a process known as liquefaction. In the upcoming days to weeks, you can expect more lesser magnitude aftershocks to occur, although the rate of such aftershocks tends to decrease with a rate of 1 over x with x representing time. The largest aftershock tends to be about 1.2 magnitudes lower than the main shock quake, and what do you know, a magnitude 6.4 aftershock struck 12 minutes after the main quake. Please, stay safe everyone.